This might be a little bit detailed for if you're just having friends around for dinner. It's more a kind of behind the scenes, in-depth analysis. And for some of the large projects I've been involved in, where it can be hundreds of support staff involved, scores of chefs, agencies, designers, all the venues. And if you think of like a VIP event, one project, for instance, could have 1,500 VIPs, press and media, or more. So there's quite a lot to organise here. Honed for many international projects, five-star hotels, launch parties, VIP receptions, whiskey festivals, cities across the globe like Dubai, Doha, Bangkok, Singapore, Hong Kong, Shanghai, Macau, and cities across America, Scotland. So let's just dive in there right now. Hello, Hendo here. Welcome to the 10 Steps to Molecular Pairing. In this video, we are going to explore deeper into the processes behind molecular pairing. If you're not familiar with molecular pairing, then I'll put a suggested video up of what is molecular pairing. And also in the context, I'll put a link to multisensory experiences because that also takes in a large part of these big creative events. We're using all the senses here. And while you're there, please tell us in the comments your favourite food and drink pairings and experiences. We'd be delighted to know what you really enjoy. So without further ado, let's dive into these 10 steps to molecular pairing. Now, as you can see here, number one is the brief. Number two is brainstorming. Number three is deconstruct. Number four is reconstruct. Number five, the liquid. Number six, lab session number one. Number seven, lab session number two. And number eight is a final countdown. And number nine is presentation. Number 10 is ready for launch. I'll go through all these now and explore each element as we go. One brief, the formation of an idea, the theme. So as you gradually go through the project, you want to keep close to you what the clients' needs are, their expectations and their values. This is super important for successful outcomes. Now, I am very highly creative, thrive in these ideation sessions. It's one of the things I really love about this. And so this would be a big part of what I would be involved in, pulling together different teams, but you'd be bringing in best practice images and things like that to show where the direction you want to go in, sketches, drawings, write down a lot of stuff because you're going to present it to other groups of people as well to share the dream, share the project. So you're going to have to get visuals down for this and this is part of the initial stage. Number two, brainstorming. So this is when the team sessions come together, can be in calls and what have you as well. So we're going to pull some ideas together. At the end of it, you want to be thinking, aiming towards four or five really solid ideas. You might have to have extra plans, A, B, C, D, and E, or even F. Some might be kiboshed for different reasons for the client purpose. So keep that in mind. You know, I was in South Africa and I was going to a pitch in Joburg from Cape Town. I was on a flight. And there was a guy beside me, a young dude who was a game farmer. And I found all the information I needed to about this. And this was very specific and needed for the project. So I was actually very lucky. I'd never been to South Africa before. Found this very useful. So on the plane, I was making tweaks to some of the pairings as I went along, as I understood more on the ground what was required. And what happened, I won the pitch on that. So very successful from the other side of the world. And you know, thanks to that chat for doing that. So brainstorming is super important. Number three is deconstruct. Now this is the analytical session where you're going to break down the aromatic volatile compounds from each concept dish. So breaking the dish right down into recipe parts and having a look at the molecular compounds that are involved and how you want to enhance them with herbs and spices or sauces, temperature, taste, sensations, you know, texture, things that you want to kind of bring to life on this, the presentation of it. So you're going to be very analytical about this, the stories that you want to tell at this stage, and really break it all down into its individual parts, first of all. So like breaking down an engine. You know, when they take a recipe and deconstruct, you hear chefs talk about deconstructing something you know, like a classic dish. So we'll do that. We've done that quite a lot, deconstructing classic dishes and putting them back, reassembling them in a different way, a different texture and temperature, what have you. So this session is the analytical section, and really we get the books out as far as chemical compounds are concerned, because it's important to get the stories right. Number four is reconstruct. So once the engine's all been pulled apart, you're going to pull that back together again. So the reconstruction of each of the elements, the ingredients of the dishes, each concept, each course, what direction you're going to go in with it. And you really want to be able to get to a kind of first draft, as it were. From there, you're going to be able to kind of continue on. But in the reconstruction, you have to think, you know, also with one eye on the computer to see if dishes have been done before, things that you haven't seen before. It's a beautiful feeling when you see that there's nothing, silence out there. So when you've created something, or your team has created something, and you come up with something really unique and something different people haven't experienced before, done that quite a few times, and Google it and it's not there. Magic feeling to see that, you know, things are not there. That's the beauty of innovation. It's not always about things that you can see. So these are some of the parts to look at as far as reconstructing, and to get the elements right in the right order for the courses. Number five, the liquid. Although you might have had some input into this in some of the previous processes, this is really where it comes to life for the liquid. So whether it's wines, whiskies and what have you. But it depends obviously on the client brief. You might already know all the things, parts of the elements of this, if you've been given by a brand, for instance. But this is where you really pull together the aromatic volatile compounds within the drink section, whether it's in the wines or the whiskies or whatever liquid that you'll be using. And this is a discovery into this. And these can be very highly creative sides to it, because you can actually create a lot of the food elements earlier on and do the liquid side later. Some people always ask, which way around would you do it? But that's the way I would do it. I've done it many, many times. But they do kind of come hand in hand. But you want to get to the end of this. You really want to know where your pairings are sitting, you know, halfway through. And number five in the liquid section, you really want to know where you're sitting with the liquids. I had a fantastic project years ago, and we had an ideation session with a cocktail created as a pairing. And we called it the 10 to 10. It was served through a syringe. And it all came to life during the brainstorming session. So it can be at the beginning or it can be in the middle section, but I tend to pop this in the middle once you get a clearer understanding what you're working with as far as the foods are concerned. Number six is lab session number one. So this is when chefs are going to come together. It's very creative, freestyle. You have the books out in the kitchen as well, cross-reference the chemistry. But it's going to be really pulling together. You want to try and get to the end of the session with things in order. But the important element of this session is going to be stress test. So cooking the dishes, see how they work. Can this be reproduced? If you're doing big projects, you've got like 1,000 guests and VIP, what have you. It can be chefs from one country and then it's passed over to a venue or a outside catering firm where they have to recreate this. So this stress test is super important. The lab session number one, you're going to try and get to see whether this is going to be possible. The ingredients, are there going to be these ingredients on the other side of the world? Is it alternatives? Can we work through? Can we give them ideas? Noting everything down. This is what happens in the number six lab session number. Number seven is lab session number two. Now, this could be an extended, you might have done, depending on the project, most of the heavy lifting in the first session, but the second session can be the back and forward and tweaking. This can be done over weeks depending on the size of the length of the project. But this can be international if you're working with chefs from here. So they might have requests internationally. Can you adjust this element, what have you? And then we go back into the lab, retest it, and see if it can be done or it can be reworked depending on the volumes that are required for the recipes and what have you. And then we can basically be solving some of the problems that could come across on the ground at the time of the project. So this is also a very key element, and comes across often in international projects when you're working remotely. Number eight is final countdown. Now this is pulling together all the pairing elements. This is where it's really going towards the end. You really want to make sure that these are all pulling together with the garnishes and the pairings, and everything is cohesive. The story is really getting there. We're really close. So this should be getting towards the sign-off side of things. But it might be that there's some aspects where you're interacting with internationally, remotely, with some of the other key aspects of the project that you're pulling this together with, or continuing on with some elements with the chefs. But this is really the final countdown. Section 8 is when you're getting to sign off, and everyone is going to be start being happy with what the outcome and the creations that you have developed with your team. Number 9 is presentation. This is going to be the photo op. So we like to sometimes take photo sessions with the pairings and all things together, if it's cocktails and food and drink together. And it's under the spotlight, see if there's any flaws. This is for VIPs, important sessions and events. So this is quite a good way to see this, but also keeps you an eye for future events, future projects that you're going to be involved in. Look back, cross-reference things, see things that you did. So this is quite a good way for a legacy as well. So number 9, the presentation, this is really the curtain call for your event. So all things are pulled together, concise, in order. You've got everything in place, ready to go. Number 10 is ready for launch. So it's showtime. Whether it's for a corporate project, FMCG, new product development, or a launch party, this is it. This is a time in the sun. It can be a very nerve-wracking experience. It's a culmination of your team's efforts. It could be for several months that you've pulled all this together. So it's exciting but nerve-wracking. And this is the big finale. You know, enjoy the moment as you are ready to launch the product for the client. I haven't mentioned anything about timescale here. Could be a year, 6 months, 3 months, a month, depends on the project themselves. So they all can be squeezed down as well, of course. I'll give you an example. It was in Joburg for a project, and there was a 27-hour flight delay, really long, terrible. But I had to, when I flew in, go straight to the venue, check with the chefs the dishes, and went straight into the CEO dinner. So yeah, we have very tight schedules. I've got many stories of tight schedules, but many of you have got project management. Everyone's got project management skills in their own lives, of course, but this is just an insight to the creative process of molecular pairing and some of the bigger projects. Please let us know in the comments if you've had experiences like this, or you've been to a wow factor food and drink experience. I find these projects fascinating. I really enjoy doing them. I'm highly creative, and I hope you find this useful in some way, and hope to see you in the next video. Thanks very much for watching.